I first met Paul Pierce when he was in the sixth grade, kid here in Inglewood attending school. We had a program here for the police department called the Police Activities League, PAL.
When I first met Paul, he was in the ninth grade, approximately 14 years of age. And he was a little chubby kid, just a real, sort of like a little butterball. And he just began to blossom from his ninth grade year to his 10th grade year.
I used to open up the gym in the morning because I was a young patrol officer working, and I'd start my shift at 7, so about 4:35 in the morning, I had keys to open the gym, and I used to open the gym for the kids that wanted to come in and work on the game to better themselves.
The beginning part of his sophomore year, we were getting ready to cut Paul, or I was getting ready to cut Paul.
He was going to cut him, and but we had a Christmas tournament, and all our big men were gone, so Paul, as a 6'3 sophomore, had to play, and he had to play center for us.
We had went into a Christmas tournament where four of my starters, because Paul wasn't a starter during that time period, four of my starters had went off on Christmas vacation, so I was really forced to play. But I had had a meeting with him prior to that, and I said, Paul, you know, I'm going to probably put you back on JVs. He didn't take that too kindly, so he wanted to come out, he wanted to show himself, he wanted to prove himself out on the basketball court, and he did just that.
And he never got off the starting lineup from there. He had obstacles to overcome, too. He had obstacles to overcome without having a dad in his home. So he grew up without his father there, although he had a very strong mother who pretty much played both roles. When we were at the draft, didn't know if he was going to be a number one or number two. But he was definitely going to be a top five pick. When that fifth pick came and he didn't get picked, we knew something was wrong. Then you fast forward to another incident where he got stabbed in a nightclub in Boston. Could have been a tragic incident, but due to him and to his credit, as hard as he worked, the determination, the time he puts in and working on his body and working on his game, how fast he bounced back. I mean, he was back before, but this happened just when he went out to get ready for training camp. During the preseason, he was already back playing. For him to come back from that kind of injury, you know, a knife inches from his heart, it could take his life. Amazing.
Paul's always talked about being a Los Angeles Laker. He's always talked about, you know, coming back to L.A. and playing. And now he's back home. So, I mean, it's fabulous for him. I think it's a situation where he can go home after the games.
Play in front of your family and friends, you know, not have enough tickets because you know everybody's going to be asking for some.
I think it's a really, really great experience for him. I think he's really looking forward to it.
Here's a guy who is a tireless worker who gives back to the community. You know, he's very family-oriented. He's got his kids now, and he's experienced. I talked to him about being a father. How's he enjoying that? It's really something he's really enjoying. To now to be coming back home, I mean, his life's come full circle. His career's come full circle. I mean, this is a dream come true.
The city of Inglewood's come a long ways in the last 4 years. We've rebuilt our finances. We've rebuilt our flagship entertainment venue, the Fabulous Forum. We've fixed our streets and trimmed our trees. But cities are much more than that. Cities have a big social component, and they have pride. And for Paul Pierce to come back here to this region and be involved with the city of Inglewood is huge, because his mere presence, for example, at the Special Olympics welcoming event we had last week, brought out so many people to see not only the Special Olympics, but to see Paul Pierce. Paul Pierce is more than a multi-million dollar basketball player. He's more than a world-class athlete. He's a person that embodies the values and virtues of hard work leading to success. And at the same time, he's kept a sense of his roots. He's humble and he's a gentleman. He's everything we want our young people to aspire to, not just in terms of financial and athletic success, but success as a man and human being.
Just so happy to have a young man like Paul to coach, and just a positive influence on his, not just on the community, but on his peers. He's also a role model, so just really a great guy.
Just to be able to see how he's grown and, you know, experience what he's experienced and what he's accomplished, it's amazing, and he's still got more to go. Welcome back, Paul.
I'm coming home.